On this heart of mine, I keep my eyes wide open all the time. I keep the ends out for the tie that binds, because you're mine, I walk the line. I find it very, very easy to be true. I find myself alone when
he's I'm Mort Cooper, your host on Change Your Voice, Change Your Life. Johnny Cash in the background, the scream on the screen, you'll know why. I can't hear what you're saying. Could you talk up? No, I have the problem. Could you talk up? Can't be heard? Let's roll, Johnny Cash on the screen.
I keep you on my mind both day and night. And
let's
happiness I've known proves that it's right. Because you're mine, I walk the line. You've got a way
Johnny Cash
to keep
sings
me
up
on
in
your
face.
Side.
He talks up
you
in the face.
He
has a sound
that
that's charming, that's lovely.
You
like to listen to Johnny Cash, so do I. Good old country music. Talks in the face.
When I talk this way, I can't be heard.
Do you have the problem you can't be heard? People ask you to talk up. Let's listen to Johnny Cash talking right up in the face. Bring that music right up on the screen.
I keep my eyes wide open all the time. I keep the ends out for the tie that binds. Because you're mine, I walk the line.
You're listening to a voice that is all there. And if your voice is not all there, do something about it. Listen to the sounds of good old country music. We're playing music that you may be able to relate to, and I hope you like. Let's roll the music. If you roll music, you hear it because it touches you. Somehow the sounds of the music we hear today is not all there. I once told my daughters I could understand one of the words in the song. Maybe she should take back the music. Let's listen to music.
Well, I'm at home a-working and a-slaving this way. You're out a-misbehaving, spending all of your pay on wine, women, and song. While I'm rob my piggy bank and spend my last thin dime on wine, women, and song. Well, one of these nights you're gonna come home. You'll find it's coming home to you. You see what you've done, and what's good for one is also good for two.
You're listening to Loretta Lynn, and her voice is right up there in the face where all good and great voices are. If you can't be heard, you're basically talking in lower throat, and that's not where you want to talk. You want to talk up in the face. If you just try a very simple, you'll feel your sound go right up into your face. Get accustomed to the hum and talk on the hum. Can't be heard? The technique will help you to be heard. I discovered it 1962 while on the staff at UCLA Medical Center. Let's listen to Loretta Lynn right up in the face.
It's all so good for two. When you're in the doghouse for that mangy old. may start to thinking and giving up your wine, women and song.
We have Hank Williams around. You listen to Hank, and you'll hear the sounds up in that face, and he can be heard. The sounds of music enchant us. We love to hear music. I love to hear good old sounds. They turn me on. Let's listen. Hank Williams.
Your cheating heart will make you weep. You'll cry and cry and try to sleep. But sleep won't come the whole night through. Your cheating heart will tell on you. When tears come down like falling rain, you'll toss around and call my name. You'll walk the floor the way I do. Your cheating heart will tell on you.
If you have a problem and you can't be heard, and you've made the rounds of the physicians, the ear, nose, and throat doctors, and you've tried the drugs and prescriptions, and you may have had surgery and you still have trouble being heard, get the idea of putting your voice up in your face. If you're talking like this, you're down here. Hank Williams has a lot of sound in his nose, and he has a great sound that we relate to. Let's tune into him and hear how he's doing.
We'll pine someday and crave the love you threw away. The time will come when you'll be blue. Your cheating heart will tell on you. When tears come down like falling rain, you'll toss around and call my name. You'll walk the floor the way I do. Your cheating heart will tell on you.
It's not working well for you, and you've tried this and that and so forth, and drugs don't work for you, and surgery may not work for you, and you have a voice that can't be heard, and you're soft-spoken, and you want to be heard. There's a way to do that. Put your voice up in the face. I'm the first part of Happy Birthday. And you'll feel the resonance up there. That's what you're listening to in good old country music. Let's listen to country music. Get a handle on it. When you get a handle on it, when you can hear it, you hear the sound up in the face. And 99% of people who are losing their voice, who have poor voices, talk in a lower throat. Let's listen to country music.
We got married in a fever, hotter than a pepper sprout. We've been talking about Jackson ever since the fire went out. I'm going to Jackson, I'm gonna mess around. Yeah, I'm going to Jackson. Look out, Jackson Town.
We'll go on down to Jackson. Go ahead and wreck your hell. Go play your hand, you big talking man. Make a big fool of yourself. Yeah, go to Jackson. Go comb your hair.
Honey, I'm gonna snowball Jackson.
See if I care.
When I breeze into that city, people gonna stoop and bow. All them women gonna make me teach 'em what they don't know how. I'm going to Jackson. You turn loose of my coat, 'cause I'm going to Jackson.
Goodbye, that's all she wrote. But till I met you in Jackson, and I'll be dancing on a pony keg. They'll lead you around town like a scalded hound with your tail tucked between your legs. Yeah, go to Jackson, you big talking man, and I'll be waiting in Jackson behind my J-Pan plan.
Yeah, we're going to Jackson. Ain't never coming back. Well, we got married in a fever, hotter than a pepper sprout. Honey, we've been talking about
Johnny Cash Jackson. Talks it, and he talks right up in the face, and he sings old country music. We're going to people who have trouble getting heard. We're going to have a rolling on a problem called the strangled voice, spasmodic dysphonia. My medical colleagues and my academician pals all say there are no cures for the problem. I've been reporting cures for over 35 years, so you might find it interesting. And we're going to play music under the sounds of the folks who had a bad voice, couldn't be heard, didn't have a voice, and squeezed, and show you how they sound now. Let's roll, rolling.
And then they put me on a stronger antibiotic, and I took that. And I began to feel good, but the voice has been a mess ever since.
I'm commission sales at Sears, and that's my livelihood, is my voice. I got so depressed just not being able to talk that it definitely affected my life.
This voice was coming. I said, God damn it.
Within a month of therapy with Dr. Cooper, I was using my voice again to the extent that I could go out on interviews and auditions, and shortly thereafter actually work.
You can hear the obstruction starting to obstruct now, I think.
This is the new voice.
There is that aspect of lightening up, but there also is an aspect of having the correct pressurization.
I don't want you to talk in that little girl's voice anymore. You talk in your regular voice. I said, but when I talk in my regular voice, you can't understand what I'm saying.
I had a strangled voice. It was very difficult to speak. When I did speak, it sounded strangled.
Before I had went ahead, worked into the position of employment director, manager of employment, and he continued to make overtures
to pick her up before too late and take her home. Do I feel that I'm likely to go back to it? No, I don't.
Ronald Finger.
Okay, how long have you had this condition?
A year and a half.
And he says, well, Ron, I'll give you three options too. He says, well, you can continue coming here for shots. You can call that doctor in California to schedule a surgery if you'd like. And then he goes, oh, by the way, Ron, there's also this other guy. Go to his website, and he wrote down his name, thevoicedoctor.com, and handed it to him. And he says, check out this guy. He says he has a cure.
And so I found on the dystonia page that something that plagued people with focal dystonia was very often spasmodic dysphonia. And they called it, multifocal dystonia.
And I, as a patient who has experienced the fear and agony of thinking that my voice is disappearing.
It just got really bad lately. It chokes up. My voice chokes up. I can't breathe. I feel like I'm running out of air.
I didn't think that it could be so simple, but it was.
With sunlight and strength, raindrops in the air, like a prism in form of a rainbow.
When the sunlight strikes raindrops in the air, they act like a prism and form a rainbow.
Gradually through a period of a year, it kept getting progressively worse where within a matter of days it would occur.
This is the patient's recovered voice.
The mastoid muscles.
And then I'd go in and start talking to my boss, and at the end of like a sentence, it would start dropping. And he'd say, what's wrong with your voice? And I'd say, I don't know.
I thought, what's happened? What have I done to myself? I know no one out there has this horrible problem I've got. But I found out there's an awful lot of people walking around out there in this world that have the spastic dysphonia.
And they say that it's because some motor signal from the brain is overamped and it tightens up the vocal cords.
It's pretty tragic, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
Pretty tragic sound, and it's quite different now.
The last time he injected me with half unit each and Botox, I completely lost my voice for 6 weeks. I was incapacitated.
It was a complete roller coaster going through that, you know, but that's the only treatment that they told me was available and that I would be getting these injections for the rest of my life.
Couldn't think of any name, and my sister and I were joking around about how many people call the rabbit's cocktail, and I just said, oh yeah, wouldn't that be fun if I called it Q-tip? So we just called it Q-tip.
You talk with the rabbit again?
Hi, Q-tip, how are you? Do you want to hop around today? Are you thirsty? Why did you bite my shoe? Well,
I'm in love. Do you realize you change your voice when you talk to the rabbit?
I talk higher.
Who diagnosed?
Scripps Hospital in La Jolla. Probably about a year and a half ago. They told me that it was neurological and I was born with it.
Other than the one time from Bryn where I had 6 months good voice, nothing.
They believe that spasmodic dysphonia is curable.
According to legend, a boiling pot of gold at one end. People look, but no one ever finds it. I've been here for the past 10 days trying to find a teaching position for the next academic year.
They didn't know what to do because they couldn't get me out of it. So eventually I went to other doctors who told me I had spasmodic dysphonia.
Trying to get help is very difficult because you can't communicate your problem or just your trials. They want you to go to psychiatrists. And how are you supposed to go to psychiatrists when you can't speak?
And then he says, well, how long ago did you see Dr. Cooper? And I went, oh my God, it's been 6 years. It'll be 6 years in June.
As I go through the day, right now I'm tending to raise my voice and go into the upper register.
You remember that voice?
I remember it.
Did you like it?
I didn't like it then, didn't like it now.
That's to help. And after a while, I get my voice not 100%, but much better than it had been. And then after about 2 years, it started to again get worse and worse.
I hope that by sharing, others too will find new hope for a life that allows them that greatest gift that God has given us, the gift that makes us human, that gift we call communication. This old world is a
bed and a doctor bill. Listening to people who are told they have a problem that's incurable, and the problem is not incurable. I've been reporting cures for 35 years by all natural approaches, while the medical community guarantees that there are no cures, and they haven't had a single cure in over 135 years. The academicians, speech therapists, do not report a single cure. You're listening to country music in the background. You're not having problems with your transmission. I want you to listen to the voices of people who put their sound up in the face. And if you do that, you can be heard. And you have an excellent opportunity to get out of the voice problems that are believed to be hopeless. It's not only the strangled voice, it's premalignancies, it's other problems. There are simple, natural approaches to help you if you have a voice problem and you can't find help. Let's listen to somebody new on the sounds of country music. Let's tune in to Johnny Cash and see what Johnny is saying. Can we? We're going to roll in just a moment. Meanwhile, we're thinking about getting your voice up in the face. If you hum the first bar of Happy Birthday, just hum it. You basically feel the sound in your face, and that's where you should be talking from. I would say about 99% of all voices that are pathological are in the lower throat, and they talk down here, so they're not heard, and they're not listened to. And people want to be heard, and they want to be listened to, but they don't know how to do it. It's simple, it's all natural, and it's here for you. Incidentally, if you want, there's self-help in the library. My book, Change Your Voice, Change Your Life, is there. It's free. And other books by me. Let's listen to Johnny Cash.
It's a burning thing, and it makes a fiery ring, bound by wild desire. I fell into a ring of fire. I fell into a burning ring of fire. I went down, 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 and the flames went higher. And it burns, 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 the ring of fire, the ring of fire.
He's talking the song, and that's the way to do it if you want to be very personable, very direct, very natural. Let's listen to Johnny.
I fell into a burning ring of fire. I went down, 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 and the flames went higher. And it burns, 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 the ring of fire, the ring of fire. The taste of love is sweet when hearts like ours meet. I fell for you like a child. Oh, but the fire went wild. I fell into a burning ring of fire. I went down, 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 and the flames went higher. And it burns, 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 the ring of fire, the ring of fire. I fell into a burning ring of fire. I went down, 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 and the flames went higher. And it burns, 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 the ring of fire, the ring of fire. And it burns, 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 the ring of fire.
Ring of fire. You have it when you can't be heard. People ask you to repeat yourself, whether you have the strangled voice or you have another problem. Voice problems are everywhere around us, and we don't understand why it happens to us. It happens because you're talking deep throat rather than in the face. The natural place to talk is in the face. If you hum the first bar of Happy Birthday, you'll feel the buzz there. Talk on the buzz. Talk throughout the day on the We're playing background music, and you got Hank Williams, who sings right up there. Let's listen to Hank Williams.
What you got cooking? How's about cooking something up with me? Hey, sweet baby, don't you think maybe we could find us a brand new recipe?
Listening to voices, there's a new recipe. Put your voice up in the face with the And if you're losing your voice, you can't be heard, and you want to be heard, get your voice up in the face. My books are free in the library. Change Your Voice, Change Your Life, 19th printing, formerly with HarperCollins for 12 years. voice suicides. Voice suicide. Stop committing it. You're doing that by talking there. And when your voice doesn't come out and people say, could you speak up, and you can't speak up, you're talking wrong. We're going to get to Johnny Cash and I Walk the Line. And we're going to close the show in just a few moments because I Walk the Line, trying to tell people they can get a great voice by talking up in the face. That's the saving grace. If you have a voice that's not working for you, and you've gone to physicians, and you've tried recipes from your friends, and it doesn't help your voice, walk the line with me and Johnny Cash, and get your voice up in your face. And that's where the saving grace is, if you want to have a voice. Get my books free in the library, don't spend a cent, and you can get the idea of how to put your voice up in the face, simply, directly, and all naturally. Isn't that what you want? Let's go with Johnny Cash. Can we put the scream on the screen? Because that's where it's all about. You're suffering with a voice problem and you don't know what to do. Bring Johnny up and let's listen to those great sounds.
I keep my eyes wide open all the time. I keep the ends out for the tie that binds. Because you're mine, I walk the line. I find it very, very easy to be true. I find myself alone when each day's through. Yes, I'll admit that I'm a fool for you. Because you're mine, I walk the line. As sure as night is dark and day is light, I keep you on my mind both day and night. And happiness I've known proves that it's right. Because you're mine, I walk the line. You've got a way to keep me on your side. You give me cause for love that I can't hide. For you I know I'd even try to turn the tide. Because you're mine, I walk the line. I keep a close watch on this heart of mine. I keep my eyes